Raja, give up all other duties and surrender unto me. While in the material world we manufacture so many duties in the name of so many isms, but our actual duty is to free ourselves from the cycle of birth and death, old age and disease. For this purpose, one must first be liberated from material bondage, and especially from household life. Household life is actually a kind of license for a materially attached person by which to enjoy sense gratification under regulated principle. Otherwise, there is no need of entering household life. Before entering household life, one should be trained as a brahmachari, living under the care of the guru, whose place is known as the Guru Kula. Brahmachari Guru Kule Vasandanto Guru Hitam. From the very beginning, a brahmachari is trained to sacrifice everything for the benefit of the guru. A brahmachari is advised to go begging alms door to door, addressing all women as mother, and whatever he collects goes to the benefit of the guru. In this way, he learns how to control his senses and sacrifice everything for the guru. When he is fully trained, if he likes, he is allowed to marry. Thus, he is not an ordinary grihastha who has learned only how to satisfy his senses. A trained grihastha can gradually give up household life and go to the forest to become increasingly enlightened in spiritual life, and at last take sannyas. Prahlad Maharaj explained to his father that to be free from all material anxiety, one should go to the forest. Hidvatma patam griham andakupam. One should give up his household, which is a place for going further and further down into the darkest region of material existence. The first advice, therefore, is that one must give up household and life, griham andakupam. However, if one prefers to remain in the dark well of household or life because of uncontrolled senses, he becomes increasingly entangled by ropes of affection for his wife, children, servants, house, money, and so on. Such a person cannot attain liberation from material bondage. Therefore, children should be taught from the very beginning of life to be first-class brahmacharis. Then it will be possible for them to give up household life in the future. To return home back to Godhead, one must be completely free from material attachment. Therefore, bhakti yoga means vairagya vidya, the art that can help one develop a taste for material enjoyment. Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Dhyana Yatasu Vairagyam Gyanam Cha Yadahaitukam. By rendering devotional service unto the personality of Godhead Sri Krishna, one immediately acquires causeless knowledge and detachment from the world. If one engages in devotional service from the beginning of life, he easily attains Vairagya Vidya or Asakti, detachment, and becomes Jitendriya, the controller of his senses. One who perfectly engages in devotional service is therefore called Goswami or Swami, master of the senses. Unless one is master of the senses, he should not accept the renounced order of life, sannyas. A strong inclination for sense enjoyment is the cause of the material body. Without full knowledge, one cannot be unattached to material enjoyment. But as long as one is not in that position, one is not fit to return home back to Godhead. Om Magyana Timurandasya Jnana Jana Salakaya Chakshuru Nimandena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovistam Stavitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Gyanmayam Jati Sopadamikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Guru Sri Rupam Sahagatam Sahagana Raghunatam Dhinam Sam Sajivam Savaitam Savadutam He's not saying don't get married, but he's saying don't get too attached. Prahlad Maharaj himself got married. He became a grihastha. And so we're not against family life, but we encourage people not to become too much involved in the sense gratification business. Prabhupada sometimes, Prabhupada told some devotees they were getting married, he told them, he said, married life means like going to a feast and fasting.
Right,
you go to a feast, you know, but you don't take prasadam, you control your senses. So married life, there's the opportunity for sense gratification there, but you don't get married just for sense gratification.
जस्तै हामी देखिन्छ कोही व्यक्ति अफिस जाँदाखेरि केही नखाइकन गएछ भने उसका इन्द्रियहरू के हुन्छ कठोर हुन्छ, त्यस्तै गरी बिहा गरेछ भने पनि यदि बिहा गरेको व्यक्तिलाई
Married life means that now you can do more service for Krishna. And you have children in Krishna consciousness and raise your children to be nice devotees of Krishna. Prabhupada explains when you're having a child in Krishna consciousness, the mother and father, they should think this child will not take birth again in the material world. This will be the last birth. So that is real Krishna consciousness, where you live together to help each other progress in Krishna consciousness. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling all of his friends, all of these people in the school with him, he's warning them about the danger of material life. We see in this lila of Prahlad Maharaj and Lord Narsingadev, we see the nature of the materialistic person very vividly, very clearly brought out in the lifestyle of the father of Prahlad Maharaj, Haranyakashipu.
Just like we see in Prahlad Ji's upadeshma or Narasimha Bhagavan's upadeshma, the sansari vyakti, kasari us sansara prasinjara bhavan dara kasari dandi dhuncha vanegura.
Right, just from his very name, Haranya means gold and Kashipu means soft bed. So materialistic people, they're very attached to these two things. They want gold, they want money, and they want a soft bed. In other words, they want sense
gratification.
Unlike all materialistic people, Haranyakashipu didn't like to die. He was making plans, making arrangements so that he could live in this world forever. Now, Haranyakashipu and his brother Haranyaksha, they were the sons of Diti. So Diti was a powerful woman, she's not an ordinary woman, and her husband was a great sage, Kashyapa. But these two sons, they were just materialists. They were just simply trying to enjoy at every opportunity. So Haranyakashipu performed great tapasya to try to get benedictions from Brahma that he would not die. Materialistic people like to worship the demigods because it's easier to please the demigods. It's not so easy to please Krishna, but it's easy to please the demigods. Lord Shiva's Ashutosh, easily pleased, but of course he's also easily angered. So Lord Brahma also, he was affected by the worship of Haranyakashipu. And he thought, let me give him some blessings. But Haranyakashipu asked him, I want the blessing that I will not die. But Brahma said, well, I can't give you that blessing because I also die. Prabhupada was saying the death rate is 100%. Everyone has to die. But people, nobody's thinking I'm going to die. So Prabhupada was living a long time.
भगवानले भन्नुहुन्छ कि 100% ग्यारेन्टी छ सबै संसार मनुष्य मर्नु पर्दछ र संसार मनुष्यले यो अलिकति पनि सोधेन कि म मर्नुपर्छ उहाँले लामो समय जिन्दगीमा सोधिरहेको हुन्छ
Sarani Kashipu tried to make some other arrangement to get immortality. He asked Brahma, bless me that I will not die in the day or in the night. I should not die on the land or in the sea or in the air. I should not die by any man or animal or demigod. So many conditions. So materialistic people are like this. They're always making so many plans to stay here forever. In China, they had emperors. Emperors would always want to have, they'd have doctors. And they would want the doctor to give them medicine so that they would live forever, that they would never die.
And
we see even the demigods and the demons, they're churning the ocean of milk. They want to get the amrit, the nectar, that nectar, to drink the nectar that they will become immortal.
त्यस्तै गरी हामीले देखिन्छ देवी देवता र असुरहरूले समुद्र मन्थन गरिरहेका छन् समुद्र मन्थनबाट अमृत निक्लिरहेको छ तर अमृत चाहिँ असुरका के भयो जहर भयो
We're thinking, if I drink that nectar of immortality, I won't die. I can live here forever. I have no anxiety.
र हामी सोच्छौँ सोचिरहेको छ यो अमृत खायौँ भने हामी अमर हुन्छौँ हाम्रो संसारमा कुनै दुःख रहँदैन इत्यादि इत्यादि सब सोचिरहेको हाम्रो मनुष्यहरूले
And Mohini Murthy, of course, came and she, when the demons got the nectar, she took it away from them and she gave it to the demigods. So we see in the material world, it's eating, sleeping, mating, and fearing. Our fear is of death.
संसारमा हामीले चारवटा कुरा देखिन्छ खानु सुत्नु अनि डराउनु अनि आफूलाई सुरक्षा राख्नु
Every living and we're all afraid, you know, we're all, what's happening, who's coming, and we live in fear of our existence, somebody threatening our existence.
हाम्रो स्थिति कस्तो हुन्छ भनेर हर पक पकमा हर क्षणसम्म हामी डरले बस्नु पऱ्यो बसिरहेको के हो गर्ने हो के बोक्ने हो कि इत्यादि बहुत खतरनाक स्थितिमा हामी बसिरहेको छौँ
We see a little bird or a little insect, they're afraid of another person. If a human comes, they'll move, they'll fly away, they'll run away. So this is a material world, we're all in fear, that we're afraid of old age, we're afraid of disease, and we're afraid of death.
यो संसारको स्थिति यस्तो छ यो संसारमा बुढो हुनुपर्छ मर्नुपर्छ बिमारी हुनुपर्छ बहुत खतरनाक स्थिति छ भन्नुहुन्छ
So how to conquer over these things? There's only one way we can conquer these things. It's only possible by surrendering to Krishna.
र यो दुःखलाई सबै दुःखलाई हामीले कसरी नाम्ने त कसरी पार गर्ने भन्दाखेरि यो दुःखलाई पार गर्ने उपाय एउटो मात्र छ के हो भन्दाखेरि भगवान्सँग शरण गर्नु कृष्णसँग शरण गर्नु
One time in America, the one young man was coming to the temple and then he said, I don't like to bow down. Why I should bow down?
And गर्दिन किनभने उनी भन्नु भन्नु भयो
Prabhupada said, oh, you do not like to bow down, but you have to bow down to old age. You have to bow down to disease. You have to bow down to death.
Yeah, ठीकै छ त यदि भगवानको अगाडि निवेदन गर्न चाहदैनस् भने त एक दिन बुढो भए हुनुपर्छ कुप्री गर्नुपर्छ बिमारको लागि त निवेदन गर्नुपर्छ अनि डरको लागि त निवेदन गर्नुपर्छ
But the devotees are happy to bow down to Krishna. You are forced to bow down, but we are happy to bow down because we are bowing down to Krishna. And by bowing to Krishna, no more old age, disease, and death.
तर हाम्रा भक्तहरूले भगवान्को अगाडि गएर निवेदन गर्नु खुसी छ तर संसारका मान्छेहरूले जबरजस्ती निवेदन गराउँछ बिमारले बुढापाले डरले तर हाम्रा भक्तहरूले भगवान्को अगाडि गएर निवेदन गरायो बहुत आनन्द दिन्छन्
So we have to say, either we surrender to Krishna or we surrender to Maya.
बाटा दुईटा मात्रै छन् या त कृष्णलाई चुन्ने या त मायासँग शरण गर्ने आफ्नो हातमा छ
We have to surrender somewhere. We make the wrong choice, we stay in the material world.
केही न केही त केही बाटोमा हिँड्ने भने या त मायाको बाटो या त कृष्णको बाटो आफ्नै हातमा छ के चुन्ने आफै सोच्ने
भन्नुहुन्छ प्रभुपाद महाराज इज इन्स्ट्रक्टिङ अल अफ अस हाउ वी कैन बिकम कृष्ण कॉन्शियस
तलाजले बहुत दिव्य उद्देश्य दिने हुन्छ कि कसरी हामी कृष्ण भावना बन्न सकिन्छौँ भनेर
And just like Prahlad being a devotee, it was very dangerous for him because his father was a great demon. So his life was threatened in so many situations.
साथसाथै अर्को प्रहलादजीको जीवनमा हेर्ने हो भने प्रहलादजी भक्त त हुनुहुन्थ्यो तर प्रहलादजीको जीवनले दुःख कसरी आएको छैन यसको यस्तो परिस्थितिमा उसको बाबुले उसलाई जागेको हो
His father tried to kill him in so many ways, but Krishna always protected him.
उसको बलराजका पिताले बलराजलाई मारलाई बहुत बार बहुत तरिकाले कोसिस गरे तर हर क्षणमा कृष्णले आएर रक्षा
गरे. This is an important point which we get from this pastime that Krishna is always willing to protect his devotee.
यो शिक्षाले हामीले बहुत महत्त्वपूर्ण ज्ञान पाइन्छ शिक्षा पाइन्छ कि यदि भक्त भगवान्सँग शरणागत भएको छ भने भगवान्ले हर तरफलाई रक्षा गर्नुहुन्छ
But Prahlad never prayed to Krishna to protect me. Prahlad never called out, oh, save me. No, Prahlad just always remembers Krishna.
प्रहलादले यतिसम्म कि कहिले भगवान्लाई प्रार्थना गर्नुहुन्थ्यो कि मलाई आएर बचाउनुहोस् प्रभु म दुःखमा छु भने श्री देवले मात्रै गर्नुहुन्छ कि भगवानको भक्ति मात्रै गर्नुहुन्छ
Gajendra, in Gajendra Moksha, we read about the elephant Gajendra fighting the crocodile. He was in great danger, he was in great distress. He called out to the Lord to come and save him. That is not pure devotion, that is Sakama
Bhakti.
But Prahlad is a pure devotee, he's a prema bhakta. He's not asking Krishna, save me, protect me. He's just simply remembering Krishna.
But Prahlad is a mahashuddha bhakta. Prahlad is a kaya vai bhavan vada bachao unho, maha suresha vada bhavan vada. Has prema bhavan hai, pasna vada bhavan hai, yad vada bhavan hai.
There was one devotee, an Indian boy. He was from South India. And he became a devotee. And his parents didn't like it. So his parents arranged for him to be kidnapped by some people and they took him away and they tried to brainwash him.
हाम्रो एउटा भक्त छन् दक्षिण भारतमा जति भक्त भक्ति मार्गमा आएर बाबामाले गुण पुऱ्याएन भक्ति भएको र बाबामाले के योजना गरे त भन्दाखेरि त्यसलाई कसैले चोरेर मतलब भएर त्यसको दिमाग बुद्धिभुटिने व्यवस्था मिलाएछ
They gave him some drugs so that he would forget everything.
उनीहरूले यस्तो गरे कि उसलाई केही न केही निशा दिए दबाई दिए कि त्यो सबैले कृष्ण उसले सबै कृष्ण भक्ति बुझो जाने
He forgot who he was, he forgot his name, he couldn't recognize his mother and father.
र ती भक्तको परिस्थिति यस्तो भयो कि उसले सबै भुले उको हो बाबाको हो म के बेकार थिएँ सब भुले छ
The only thing he could remember was
Hare Krishna. तर उसले एउटा मात्रै याद गरेछ के हो त भन्दाखेरि हरे कृष्ण भनेर भन्छ
They
give him
the medicine to forget everything. The only thing he could remember
was
the Maha Mantra. Because the Maha Mantra is not material. The merits that made him forget everything in the material world, but it couldn't act on the memory of the holy name.
Maharaj Vandana, yo, pastama yo, Bhagwan ko naam yo, samsaro chiz hoy na, jese karan samsaro dabai yo, samsaro chiz sabai na bhulana sakcha, tarai divya dham ko yo naam na je bhulana sakcha, na sakdaina bhancha.
So he's a nice devotee. He came back again after some time. He came back to Krishna consciousness. So the same way Prahlad Maharaj, even though they're trying to kill him, even though they do so many things, they put him in the bottom of a well with poison snakes, or they have an elephant trample over him, or they throw him off a mountain, but he just remembers Krishna. So, because he's a pure devotee, he sees Krishna everywhere, in everything.
Oh,
Krishna says like this in the Bhagavad Gita, that for one who sees me everywhere, I am never lost to him, nor is he ever lost to me. So Haranyakashipu asked his son, where is this God? Where is you, this God that you're worshipping? Is he in here? Is he in this pillar? And Prahlad said, yes, yes, father, he's there. And so Lord Narsingadeva appeared from the pillar. So we see the inconceivable potency of the Supreme Lord, that he can appear everywhere from anything. Just like Lord Varaha, where does Lord Varaha appear from?
Varaha Bhavan ka nahi pakadu ma udhavari.
Yeah, from the nose, right? From the nose of Lord Brahma. Yeah, you know, not a, you think, oh, a dirty thing coming out of the nose. But Lord Varaha came out of the nose of Brahma. And the same way Lord Narsingadeva appeared from the pillar. So the Lord can appear in any way, in so many different ways, inconceivable things. And when he appears, he can appear in any different form he likes. The Lord Narsingadeva is not animal and he's not man. He's half man, half animal. So we wonder, what kind of creature is this? This is no ordinary creature. This is the Supreme Lord himself. He can appear. He appears in so many different ways just to give pleasure to his devotee and also to have to deal with different demons like
Haranyakashipu.
Because Lord Brahma had given so many benedictions to Haranyakashipu that he would not be killed here, he would not be killed like this, he could not be killed in that way. So Lord Narsingadeva had to keep all these benedictions intact because Lord Brahma is his devotee. So he has to keep intact all these benedictions which Brahma had given. And at the same time he has to kill Haranyakashipu.
नरसिंह भगवान ने इस तो अद्भुत कार्य करवाया कि परमा जी दिए को पर्दा ना सब ही पर्दा ना हेरने में शंकर पूरा होना मेरा सासा हेरने में शंकर लाइफ वाली मानी की ना छोड़ने वाला
और सो आफ्टर ही किल्ड हर हिरण्यकशिपु ही टोल्ड लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा डोंट यू गिव एनी मोर बेनेडिक्शंस अगेन You give me a lot of trouble just because of you giving all these benedictions. I have to do all these things. So Lord Nrsingadev got very angry because of Harani Kashipu. Kashipu was treating his devotee
Prahlad.
Lord Nrsingadev was so angry because the Lord always wants to protect his devotee and he saw Prahlad being put through so many tough, difficult situations. Harani Kashipu trying to kill his son, but he could not kill him.
So Vasudev Hirani Kashipu said, "Bichara Prahlad, you are both Prahlad, you are both Sadarudra. This is why Bhagavan ko khun taati ungli daya the one both both Mahabhuto."
So after finally Lord Nrsingadev came and killed Harani Kashipu, then he was still very angry.
So Bhagavan antim ma Hirani Kashipu le maari nu bhayo, maari sangai pani Bhagavan ko krodh kamti bhayo na is visaya ma bhayo.
We know sometimes you get angry, you know, even though, you know, we may do something to adjust the situation, to make it nice again, to make it pleasant, but still you feel very angry. The anger hasn't gone away. You know, sometimes people are angry not just for, you know, half an hour, but, you know, a few days, several days they're angry. You can't speak to them, you know, you can't look at them, you know, they get angry.
So
Lord Nrsingadev, he was Ukra Nrsinga, he was very angry because Harani Kashipu had done so many bad things to
Prahlad.
So they tried to pacify him and they thought maybe send Lakshmi there. Lakshmi is the wife because Lord Nrsingadev is Vishnu. And Lakshmi is the concept of Vishnu, so let Lakshmi go before Lord Nrsingadev and maybe when he sees his wife he will calm down. But when Lakshmi came, Lord Nrsingadev is still angry, he's still very angry, he could not calm down, even seeing his wife, it did not make any difference.
अपने पत्नी लक्ष्मी देवी और लक्ष्मी माता आना बनी भगवान लक्ष्मी ने देखो क्रोध अधे मारे गए थे ना ऐ तुम्हें कहाँ नहीं आ रही है तुम लोग मस्त आ रहे हैं अपने भगवान लक्ष्मी ने
So then they put Prahlad forward, and then Lord Nrsingadev saw Prahlad, then he changed and he felt very sorry, he felt very compassionate for And at that time he brought Prahlad, he sat Prahlad on his lap. Now in previous incarnations the Lord had been, you know, he'd been Kurma Avatar and Matsya Avatar. Like this, he had not experienced this relationship of being a father. Vamanadeva, the dwarf, you know, the dwarf incarnation, he didn't have any wife or children then also. But when Prahlad comes, you know, he puts his hand on the head of Prahlad, and he develops this Vatsalya Ras. He develops this mood of being like a father to Prahlad. So this gave Lord Vishnu more desire to experience this Vatsalya Ras. So you see later in other incarnations, then he becomes married and he has children. So Lord Narsingadev likes to experience all these different rasas. So Lord Narsingadev also appeared in this Kali Yuga. He came at Navadvip Dham and he appeared to the demon, to the Chankasi. Because the Chankasi broke in the Danga drum and he ordered all the devotees, no more Sankirtan, stop this Sankirtan. So because the Chankasi broke the Madanga and stopped the Sankirtan, so that night when he went home, Lord Narsingadev appeared to the Chankasi. The Chankasi met with Lord Chaitanya and he told Lord Chaitanya how this very ferocious, very angry form, half man, half wine, had appeared to him and sat on his chest and grabbed him and threatened him that if you ever break the Madanga drum again, then I will rip you to shreds. And just to show Chankasi how serious he was, he ripped open his shirt and he dragged his nails across his chest. And when the Chankasi opened his shirt to Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya saw all the marks, the claws of the lion on his chest. So we also give great importance to the worship of Lord Narsingadev. Prabhupada taught us that when he was very ill one time, he asked Prabhupada, is there anything we can do to help for your health? And Prabhupada suggested that we could put a picture of Lord Narsingadev on the water and we could also chant in the Shringa prayer after the arti. We finish with Lord Narsingha prayers, and Prabhupada said this will help to protect our movement and it will also protect the spiritual teachers. Now, some people like to put Lord Ganesh over the door of their house because they say Ganesh is Vigna Vinaya. He destroys the obstacles and the path of our devotion. So they often put Lord Ganesh
there.
But we can also put Lord Narsingadev there because Lord Narsingadev also is Vigna Vinaya. He also destroys the obstacle. There's a prayer in Srimad Bhagavatam offered by Prahlad Maharaj to Lord Narasimhadev. He said, Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya Namaste Jas Tejase Abir Abir Baba Braja Naka Braja Damstra Karmashraya Randaya Randaya Tamo Grisa Grisa Om Swaha Abayam Abayam Atmani Bhuvishtam Om Shrom. Prahlad Maharaj is saying, I offer my respectful obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narasimhadev, who possesses nails and teeth like thunderbolts. And Prahlad said, kindly vanquish our demonic-like desires for fruitive activities. Please appear in our heart and drive away our ignorance. Please help us to become fearless in our struggle for existence in this material world. So whenever we are in any kind of danger, we should call out to Lord Narasimhadev.
It's
a good, very important prayer to remember. So this Sunday we will celebrate the appearance day of Lord Narasimhadev. It's a Purnima. Right. Usually we will fast until the sunset or the moonrise. That means until the evening. And we will break fast in the evening. Yeah, we have a courtesy for starting. Okay, any questions? Some people worship Lord Narasimhadev. You know, they're more attracted to worship Lord Narasimhadev than to worship Lord Krishna or Lord Rama. They like to worship Lord Narasimhadev. I was in Nepal just 2 months ago, and I saw many temples there in Kathmandu. They have Lord Varaha and Lord Narasimhadev, either side. And in South India, there's a Varaha Narasimha. There's a combined form, Lord Varaha and Lord
Narasimhadev.
Prahlad Maharaj wanted to see the form, both the incarnations in the one form. Yes, Prabhu.
Maharaj, this Prahlad Maharaj get a knowledge from his womb, and nowadays there is all Matajis, they are not actively what would like to come to the temple. So what is the opportunity to get a learn from womb of mother, and what is the best way for them?
Maharaj,
ಜನರು.
So a woman carrying a child, they should regularly hear the scriptures. They don't need to come to temple. You have television, you have mobile phones, you have so many other technology to hear devotees speaking and to listen to the Lord's pastimes.
गर्भवती माताजीले यदि मन्दिर आउने स्थिति परिस्थिति ठिक भएन भए त पनि अहिले हाम्रो फोनहरू छ, टिभीहरू छन्, त्यो त्यसको माध्यमद्वारा भगवान्को कथा हमेसा सुन्नु पर्दछ भनेर.
You don't have to come to the temple, you can do it in your own home, where bhakti yoga can be done anywhere, wherever you are.
मन्दिर मात्रै आएर गर्छु भन्ने होइन, भक्ति यो घरमा पनि गर्न सकिन्छ. यो भक्ति योग यस्तो छ कि जहाँ भए पनि यो भक्तिलाई सम्पन्न गर्न सकिन्छ.
Make our home the give it a spiritual atmosphere by our devotional activities.
यो भक्तिको सेवाको माध्यमद्वारा हाम्रो भक्ति भएर हामीले बढाउन सकिन्छ.
By having regular kirtan in your home, you do kirtan, you do tulsi puja.
हमेशा घरमा कीर्तन गर्नुपर्छ, तुलसी पूजा गर्नुपर्छ.
And then play the music, play different kirtans, listen to lectures.
सिडी टिभीमा हालेर गाना सुन्ने होइन, कीर्तन सुन्नु पर्दछ. बल हाम्रो भक्तिलाई अगाडि बढाउँछ.
It's not only the duty of the mother, father also has a responsibility.
यो होइन माता आमाले मात्रै मैले भुँडी भयो भने मैले मात्रै सुन्नुपर्छ भने होइन, बाबुले पनि त्यसलाई सहयोग गर्नुपर्छ यसलाई कथाहरू सुनाउनको लागि.
So we should not be neglectful, we should take care.
हामीले तिनीहरूलाई एकदम त्यागी यसो हुने होइन, हामीले एकदम उनीहरूलाई सुरक्षापूर्वक राख्नु पर्दछ.
We would often give the Mahaprasadam to the lady who is carrying a child.
हामीले अवसर के गरिन्छ त भन्दाखेरि भुँडी भएका माताजीलाई प्रसाद दिने गर्छ.
We want the child to get the Mahaprasada.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. He's already given us so much, right? He's given us so many things in this life. We have so much to be thankful for. We don't like to take more service from Krishna.
We want to give service. So we encourage all of you to continue with your nice preaching, nice programs here in Koh Samui. Want to see more and more devotees. I think there are still many more people who can become devotees here.
महाराजले भन्नुहुन्छ र यसरी नै सबै मिलेर लागेर जानुहोस्. तपाईँहरूको काम भएको समयमा अझ धेरै मान्छे छन्, कृष्ण भक्तिमा प्रार्थना गरेका र सबैले यसरी मिलेर प्रचार गर्नुहोस्, यो भावना अगाडि बढाउनुहोस् भन्नुहुन्छ.
We want to see all of you become pure devotees, right? Make good progress in Krishna consciousness. Initiation is the beginning. Doesn't mean that I'm initiated now and going back to Godhead. No, initiation is only the beginning. Nice dramas, I was hearing you do nice drama. So, like this, more and more people will be
attracted.
So we will have Rath Yatra in Bangkok on July 8th. It's a Sunday. If any of you are able to come,
July 8th, I will pray for our Rath Yatra. Only child, who will come? Who will come? Hariyo.
They are in a big bus.
We'll try.
Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai,
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai,
Gaur Premananda ji.
Hariyo.
So, on behalf of all the customer devotees, now I thank Maharaj for visiting to our place. Although this is quite far up from Bangkok, not a straight direct bus or difficult, but Maharaj is still kind, Maharaj is still coming. So we have also requested Maharaj, please visit to us at least once a year. Maharaj said he will try, so I hope Maharaj will come. So really thank you Maharaj for visiting to us in your old days actually. So we hope Maharaj will come again and again. And will give us a chance to serve you and please give us more Krishna Katha. Hare
Bol!
Let us chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra one time.
Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Hare Hare. Param Pujya Narasimha Swami Maharaj ki
jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Nitai Gaur Premanande.
Hare Bol.
I'm going to go to the house. भोलि सुन त मैले बेगी ल्याइने छु, मलाई पैसा चाहियो, यसले ल्याए कि बेगी ल्याएको छु रात क्याएको होइन हरि हरि भो हरि भो माताजी लु भन त आज कस्तो अनि अब आइतबार प्रोग्राम छ सबैलाई इन्भाइट गर्ने छिटो रामाजी फोनमा त बोलिन्छ त मजाले छिटो
एकदम फर्स्ट क्लास राम्रो हुनुपर्छ
आज लास्ट डे हो अनि हामीहरूको आइतबार प्रोग्राम हुन्छ भनौँ यो बेच्ने हुनु क्या कता
होइन
यो मैले उतो निकाल्ने हो र